Hello, everyone. My name is Kim Bays, and I am the chief of school. What that means is that I am the lucky person who gets to support all of your principals, who support all of your teachers, who support all of you. So it's a really lucky position that I'm in. And I am so thrilled to be able to read aloud to you today. I have been a teacher too, and I miss reading to students. So today I'm going to read to you a story about a little boy who's younger than all of you. I'm not going to tell you how old he is, but he's little. And the book is called Trombone Shorty, and it is written by Troy Trombone Shorty Andrews. That means this is a biography about this little guy, and you're going to see some surprising pictures when we get to the end of it. It's a book all about music. Where yet? Where yet? We have our own way of living down here in New Orleans, and our own way of talking, too. And that's what we like to say when we want to tell our friends hello. Where you at? Lots of kids have nicknames, but I want to tell you the story of how I got mine. Just like when you listen to your favorite song, let's start at the beginning, because this is a story about music. But before you can understand how much music means to me, you have to know how important it is to my hometown, my greatest inspiration. I grew up in a neighborhood in New Orleans called Tremé. Any time of day or night, you could hear music floating in the air. And there was music in my house, too. My big brother James played the trumpet so loud that you could hear him halfway across the town. He was the leader of his own band, and my friends and I would pretend to be in the band, too. Do you all have a big brother? Do you pretend to be in a band sometimes? There's one time every year that's more exciting than any other. Mardi Gras. Parades fill the streets and beaded necklaces are thrown through the air to the crowd. I loved the brass bands with their own trumpets, trombones, saxophones, and the biggest brass instrument of them all, the tuba, which rested over the musician's head like an elephant's trunk. Where yet? Where yet? The musicians would call. All day long, I could see brass bands parade by my house while my neighbors danced along. I loved those parades during Mardi Gras because they made the streets come alive and made people forget about their troubles for a little while. People didn't have a lot of money in Tremé, but we always had a lot of music. I listened to all those sounds and mixed them together, just like how we make our food. We take one big pot and we throw in sausage, crab, shrimp, chicken, vegetables, rice, whatever's in the kitchen, and stir it all together and let it cook. When it's done, it's the most delicious taste you have ever tried. We call it gumbo. And that's what I wanted my music to sound like. Different styles combined to create my own musical gumbo. It's gonna make us hungry, isn't it? But when I needed an instrument, the great thing that I thought about music is that you don't even have to have a real instrument to play. So my friends and I decided to make our own. Have you ever made music with your own hands and your own mouth? Well, don't do it now. Save it until you go outside. We might have sounded different from the real brass bands, but we felt like we were the greatest musicians of Tremé. We were making music, and that's all that mattered. And then, one day, I found a broken trombone that looked too beaten up to make music anymore. It didn't sound perfect, but finally, with a real instrument in my hand, I was ready to play. The next time the parade went by my house, I grabbed that trombone and headed out into the street. My brother James noticed me playing along and he smiled proudly. "Trombone Shorty," he called out, because the instrument was twice my size. "Where you at?" From that day on, everyone called me Trombone Shorty. I took that trombone everywhere I went and I never stopped playing. I was so small that sometimes I fell right over to the ground because it was so heavy. But I always got back up, and I learned to hold it up high. I listened to my brother play songs over and over, and I taught myself those songs too. I practiced day and night, and sometimes I fell asleep with my trombone in my hands. Have you ever fallen asleep with something special? It's pretty magical. One day, my mom surprised me with tickets to the New Orleans Jazz and Heritage Festival, the best and biggest music festival in town. We went to see Bo Diddley, who my mom said was one of the most important musicians of all time. As I watched him on stage, I raised my trombone to my lips and started to play along. He stopped his band in the middle of the song and he asked the crowd, "Who's that playing out there?" Everyone started pointing, but Bo Diddley couldn't see me because I was the smallest one in the place. So my mom held me up in the air and said, "That's my son, Trombone Shorty." "Well, Trombone Shorty, come on up here," Bo Diddley said. The crowd passed me overhead until I was standing on the stage right next to Bo Diddley himself. I walked right up to the microphone and held my trombone up high in the air, ready to blow. "What do you want to play?" Bo Diddley asked. "Follow me," I said. After I played with Bo Diddley, I knew I was ready to have my own band. I got my friends together and we called ourselves the 5 o'clock band because that was the time we went out to play every day after finishing our homework. Just like you, right? We played all around New Orleans. I practiced and practiced, and soon my brother asked me to join his band. When people wondered who lived in the band and who played, he would say proudly, "That is my little brother, Trombone Shorty. Where are you at?" And now I have my own band called Trombone Shorty and Orleans Avenue, named after a street in Tremé. I've played all around the world, but I always come back to New Orleans. And when I'm home, I make sure to keep my eyes out on the younger musicians in town and help them out, just like my brother did for me. Today I play at the same New Orleans Jazz Festival where I played with Bo Diddley. And when the performance ends, I lead a parade of musicians around, just like I used to do in the streets of Tremé with my friends. Where you at? Where you at? I still keep my trombone in my hands, and I will never let it go. Now, do you want to see something really special? These were beautiful illustrations, but now I'm going to show you some photographs of the real Trombone Shorty, and I want you to see how little he was. See if you can take a look at this one. Can you see him down there? Remember the story said the trombone was twice his size? You can see it is. And if you take a look at this one, look how little that little guy is. He's younger than all of you. And that was him playing in the streets of New Orleans and up on stage. So you want to see what he looks like now, all grown up? Here he is. And you know he still plays? And do you know he has even played here in Tampa? So this just goes to show you that you can start playing music anytime you want, at any age, and you can become anything you want to. Thank you, everyone.